Good morning. Welcome back. So today we'll go for two more Boolean theorems, that is absorption law and De Morgan theorems. Okay, we are going to solve these two theorems algebraically. The first theorem is absorption law, that is x plus x dot y is equal to x. X dot x plus y is equal to x, and the second one is De Morgan theorem, that is x plus y whole dash is equal to x dash dot y dash. X dot y whole dash is equal to x dash plus y dash. Okay, so the first law is very simple. Absorption law, proving the absorption law is very simple. If I am taking the first law, that is x plus x dot y is equal to x, on the left hand side if I am taking, that is x plus x dot y. Now taking common x, I have x dot 1 plus y. Now applying properties of 1 over here, if I am applying properties of 1, 1 plus y is equal to 1, so that the expression now become x dot 1. Again using properties of 1, we have x dot 1 is equal to x. So the expression is x, which is nothing than the right hand side value. So this is the proof of your absorption law. And the second absorption law, the second part of absorption law using AND operator, that is x dot x plus y is equal to x. So here also I am taking the left hand side. Now x dot x plus y. So expanding the expression, this become x dot x plus x dot y. X dot x plus x dot y. Now x plus l, by independence law, x is equal, x dot x is equal to x, x plus x is equal to x. So x dot x is replaced by x. Now the expression is x plus x dot y. So taking common x, we have 1 plus y using properties of 0. 1 plus y can be replaced as 1. Again using properties of 1, we can replace x dot 1 as x, which is nothing than the right hand side of algebra, and the law has been proved. Okay. Now come to the De Morgan theorem. In case of De Morgan theorem, we have to use some different strategy here, and when deriving the expression, both left hand side as well as the right hand side, and getting a common value from the left hand side as well as the right hand side. That means you have to evaluate both left hand side expression as well as the right hand side expression algebraically, and both the side will have to get a common value. Okay, for that the first expression is, suppose the first expression we have the first expression, that is x plus y whole dash is equal to x dash dot y dash. Now I'm taking the value of both the side, x plus y whole dash. Now if I am multiplying or a dot operator I am using over here with x plus y, so the same thing I have to do in the right hand side, x dash dot x plus y. On both the side I have multiplied, or I have using an AND operator with the value x plus y. Now according to complementary rule, what is the complementary rule? X dot x dash is equal to 0, x plus x dash is equal to 1. Now taking this total x plus y as x, if you are considering this x plus y as x, then what happened? X dash dot x, which is nothing than the your complementary law. So using the complementary law, x plus h dash is equal to 0. So the left hand side is become now 0. And the right hand side we have to derive a 0. So that simply expand this expression. In fact, expanding this expression, x dash dot y dash will be multiplied or ended with x. X dash dot y dash will be ended with y. So when we are expanding this, what happened? X dash dot y dash dot x. X dash dot y dash dot x plus x dash dot y dash dot y. Now again using the complementary law, suppose for the commutative, I am using commutative over here, that become x dash dot x dot y, and here the same thing is that is x dash dot y dash dot y. So here x dash dot x using the complementary law, this is 0 dot y and this is y dash dot y is equal to 0, so this becomes x dash dot 0. So the expression is now 0 over here, 0 over here, 0 dot y is equal to 0, that is properties of 0, plus y x dash dot 0 is also 0 using the properties of 0, so the value is now 0. This is the left hand side we derived as 0, and the right hand side also we have derived to 0. This is the proof of first De Morgan theorem. Okay, in case of the second De Morgan theorem, we have to use the same concept over here. The second theorem is, the second part of De Morgan theorem is x dot y whole dash is equal to x dash plus y dash. Okay, here also we are deriving both the side to a common value. Okay, both the side a common value you have to derive for that. Okay, suppose x dot y whole dash, I am using the AND operator for x dot y, and here also we have to use the same thing, x dash plus y dash whole AND by x dot y. Okay, now what happened? Same thing using complementary rule, that is x, suppose this x dot y we are considering as x, so x dash is equal to 0 over here in the right hand side, let's derive to 0. Now expand this expression, that means we have to multiply x dot y with x dash as well as with y dash. So first expression should be x dot y dot x dash plus x dot y dot y dash. Okay, so again here we have 0 using the commutative law, x dot x dash dot y plus same thing over here, x dot y dash. Now apply complementary rule for x plus x dash and x dot x dash and y dot y dash. Okay, so what happened? The left hand side is 0, the right hand side is 0 dot y plus here x dot 0. Again by using properties of 0, 0 dot y is equal to 0 plus x dot 0 is equal to 0. So 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. Now we have the same value at the left hand side as well as the right hand side. So this is the HS and this is the RHS. Okay. So this is the proof of your second part of De Morgan theorem. Okay. For today, this much, and this is the last topic of your algebraic verification of Boolean algebra or theorems of Boolean algebra. Okay. In the next class, we'll go for the logic gates and the Boolean logic circuit. After that, thank you and have a nice day.